Attention, future visionaries. Welcome to the dawn of vacuum maglev, the ultra-futuristic transportation technology that's shattering the limits of physics, gravity, and national borders, where traveling 1,000 kilometers in just under 30 minutes becomes reality without flying. While most people are still talking about electric cars and bullet trains, a silent revolution is underway, and countries like China, Japan, the US, and Germany are racing to dominate it. China's top-secret T-Flight Hyperloop, backed by its military aerospace giant, known as China Aerospace Science and Industry Corporation, just shattered records with a 623 miles per hour test run in a low vacuum tunnel, edging closer to its 1,000 miles per hour target, aiming to operate its first operational Hyperloop maglev line by 2035, while Elon Musk's Hyperloop is still in the R&D phase. But China isn't alone. Japan's SC Maglev, 374 miles per hour, and the U.S.'s Maryland SC Maglev, funded by $27 million federal grants, are racing to dominate this $100 billion transportation revolution. The Maglev train market is set to skyrocket from $3.8 billion in 2025 to $59.3 billion by 2034. But behind the scenes, massive challenges threaten this technology, from vacuum tube, safety maintenance nightmares, to energy demands, and insane infrastructure costs. Worse, accidental depressurization at supersonic speeds could be deadly, and 5G blackouts in vacuum tubes remain unsolved. Also, who is funding this? Is it global tech giants, venture capitalists, and even oil-rich nations seeking next-generation transport control? The dark sides are surveillance fears, environmental concerns, and a future where only the elite control the fastest way to move across the Earth. As the geopolitical battle intensifies, vacuum maglev is no longer just science fiction. It's a war over speed supremacy, global mobility, and economic power. From massive funding battles to engineering disasters that could kill thousands, we are about to expose the hidden truth and the mind-blowing potential of this game-changing vacuum maglev technology that world powers are desperately fighting to control. Get ready to be amazed and stay tuned for the full story. You don't want to miss it. Before we dive deeper, prepare to have your mind blown by the insane science that powers these vacuum maglev trains of the future. The secret lies in a blend of magnetic levitation, quantum-level propulsion systems, and near-zero air resistance created by high-tech vacuum tubes. Unlike traditional trains, maglevs don't run on wheels. Instead, it uses superconducting magnets, which are cooled to -321 degrees Fahrenheit, that create unbreakable magnetic fields, levitating the train 10 centimeters above the track, eliminating friction entirely. No wheels, no friction, just pure magnetic defiance of gravity. But the real magic lies with near-perfect vacuum tubes that eliminate 99.9% of air resistance, allowing speeds faster than a jet. Imagine New York to LA in just 30 minutes. These futuristic trains are powered by linear electric motors and magnetic fields, controlled by AI-powered stabilizers that calculate levitation and acceleration in real time, perfectly balanced at hypersonic speeds. It's the same tech used in particle accelerators. The only difference is currently it's moving people instead of atoms. Countries like China and Japan are investing billions to master this next generation transport race, and even Elon Musk's Hyperloop vision draws from the same core science. But the real question is, how far can we push this? Can we reach hypersonic rail travel or even build vacuum maglev networks across continents and oceans? Strap in, because what powers these machines is more than science. It is the start of a new era in global mobility. Now let's see what makes vacuum maglev different from hyperloops. Here is what happens when two of the world's most futuristic transportation technologies go head to head. Both promise travel speeds over 1,000 kilometers per hour, frictionless movement, and an end to air travel as we know it, but their technology is radically different. As we already know, vacuum maglev uses magnetic levitation inside vacuum-sealed tubes, lifting trains off the track with superconducting magnets and propelling them using linear electric motors already tested in countries like China and Japan. Meanwhile, the Hyperloop, first popularized by Elon Musk, uses airless pods blasted through low-pressure tunnels at near supersonic speeds, with concepts under development in the US, UAE, and India. But here's the twist. While Hyperloop dazzles with futuristic flair, real-world vacuum maglev systems are already breaking ground. China recently tested a 620 kilometers per hour prototype, and Japan's SC Maglev has hit 603 kilometers per hour on test tracks. So, which one will win the race? Is Hyperloop just hype or the next leap in mass transportation? Can vacuum maglev scale to intercontinental networks or even underwater? The science is mind-blowing. The stakes are global, and the implications could redefine how humanity connects across the planet. Buckle up, because this is more than a comparison. It's a glimpse into the transportation revolution that could reshape cities, borders, and economies forever. On the other hand, China leads the pack with jaw-dropping prototypes, including a 620 kilometers per hour vacuum maglev already on test tracks and a classified mega network linking megacities in under an hour. Japan follows with its iconic SCMaglev, which hits 603 kilometers per hour using superconducting magnets and now eyes vacuum integration for intercity transit. Germany, the birthplace of maglev, is quietly reviving its trans-rapid tech with futuristic upgrades, including European-wide vacuum rail corridors. The United States is betting big with Virgin Hyperloop and Elon Musk's Hyperloop vision, which heavily borrow from vacuum maglev principles and could connect cities like LA to Vegas in minutes. And then there's South Korea, pushing for domestic maglev vacuum fusion systems to future-proof their national infrastructure. This isn't just transportation, it's a technological arms race where nations are battling for global dominance in the next generation mobility market. But the big question is, which country will control the fastest, cleanest transport system ever invented? And how safe is this next generation engineering marvel? Experts are split. On one hand, magnetic levitation eliminates wheel track friction, reducing mechanical failure, while the vacuum environment removes weather-related risks like turbulence, ice, or debris. These trains are AI-controlled, with real-time monitoring systems and emergency pressure regulation built into the tubes. As countries like Japan and China already tested these systems at near supersonic speeds, claim zero accident potential due to the system's sealed, automated nature. But what happens in a sudden power outage or when an earthquake strike? Could a depressurization event at 1,000 kilometers per hour be catastrophic? Some engineers fear the lack of escape mechanisms, while others warn about the cost of fail-safe redundancies. Yet, despite these concerns, governments are pouring billions into maglev infrastructure, calling it safer than any mass transport ever invented. On the other hand, how much will a vacuum maglev ticket cost, and will you be able to afford it? Rumors are swirling that early rides could cost $5,000+ per seat reserved for billionaires and black card elites. But insiders now claim next-generation AI-run systems could slash ticket prices to under $50, cheaper than a bus pass. China's prototype has already achieved 1,000 kilometers per hour, and sources say governments are negotiating mass affordability subsidies to make this tech mainstream by 2030. Imagine commuting from San Francisco to Seattle in 15 minutes on a student budget. Sounds impossible, right? Saudi Arabia's NEOM is developing a magnetic tube system integrated directly into cities. And Elon Musk's Hyperloop spinoff is reportedly using blockchain-backed ticketing to keep costs lower than commercial airlines. But who is paying for this futuristic freedom, and what's the real catch behind the ticket price war? Are we being promised affordability while the elite preparing for exclusive high-speed corridors only they can access? Behind the glossy tech and billion-dollar promises lies a shadowy side no one is ready to talk about. Vacuum maglev trains, the sleek symbols of ultra-speed and zero-emission travel, may be hiding a darker, more dangerous side. What happens when a capsule traveling at 1,000 kilometers per hour suffers a system glitch? Inside a near vacuum, even a millisecond delay in emergency response could mean catastrophic implosion. While corporations promise, AI-based fail-safes, and quantum emergency override systems, leaked documents suggest countries are scrambling to build military-grade backup tunnels, fearing weaponized sabotage. And here is where it gets even wilder. The global race for maglev dominance isn't about convenience, it's about control. The US, China, Russia, and the UAE are reportedly embedding classified surveillance tech inside maglev infrastructures, turning transportation corridors into real-time data collection highways. What if your daily commute becomes part of a geopolitical surveillance war? And while governments claim they are building these systems for the people, whistleblowers say, there is a secret tier of elite-only vacuum pods equipped with escape hatches, EMP shielding, and direct access to underground bunkers. This isn't just about speed, it is about power, secrecy, and control. So, the next time you hear about vacuum maglev's bright future, remember the invisible wars, the hidden risks, and the protocols, written in code, not laws. Smash that like if you believe the truth about our future shouldn't be locked behind magnetic walls. And subscribe, because in the world of vacuum maglev, speed is everything, but knowledge is survival.